Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. So, a few months back, I did the Dell PowerEdge C6520 server node supported in the C6400 chassis. You can see it here. Today we have the successor to that platform, the Dell PowerEdge C6620 server node supported by the Dell PowerEdge C6600 chassis. The C6620 is a half-width, nearly 1U server with support for dual 4th or 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors, up to 4 terabytes of memory, and the C6600 chassis supports a number of storage options. Click that subscribe button if you want more notifications when we drop a new video. Let's get to it. Offering high compute performance with dual sockets for scale-out workloads, the Dell PowerEdge C6620 is a shoe-in for deep learning and data analytics. The PowerEdge C6600 chassis provides the storage, cooling, and power. I will mention there is another server node supported by the C6600 chassis, the PowerEdge C6615 server node. That one offers a single AMD EPYC CPU with up to 64 cores and 576 gigabytes of memory max. With both options, you can install up to 4 hot swap server nodes per 2U chassis. Outfitted with dual 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs with up to 64 cores each, each Dell C6620 server can support up to 128 physical processing cores and 256 virtual threads using Intel's hyper-threading technology. System-wide, that would be up to 512 physical cores and up to 16 terabytes of DDR5 memory in a 2U enclosure with options for SAS, SATA, and NVMe storage. This seems like a good time to mention server nodes have to be the same model number, no mix and match supported. The front of the chassis is where all the storage is located, aside from the optional boot-optimized storage subsystem or BOS to boot the server nodes, but we'll get to that. The storage bays on the front of the chassis are equally divided between the storage nodes. Storage options for the Dell C6620 server node include up to 16 SAS SATA drives using the standard backplane or up to 16 SAS SATA or NVMe drives using the universal backplane. That would provide for 2 SAS SATA drives and 2 universal slots that could host SAS SATA or NVMe drives per node. Another configuration includes up to 8 E3.S NVMe SSDs with 2 assigned to each server node. And then there's our system we have today. Not surprisingly, we have the one with no backplane, and as a result, no storage in front, with the server nodes used primarily for compute, analysis, or perhaps a host for a storage array. I say no surprise, because why don't we ever get the cool stuff? I mean, like that one with the 8 E3.S drives. Eventually we will, but not in time for this video. Additional 80 millimeter fans occupy some of what would be the drive cage areas. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge C6620 server node? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that's listed or one that you can configure at itcreations.com that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video to reap the rewards. Each control panel has an on button and system status ID button for 2 server sleds. The left supports server sleds 1 and 2, while the right server ear is for sleds 3 and 4 with an information pullout right beside it. On the back of the C6600 chassis, you can see the 4 server nodes with sleds 1 and 2 on the right and 3 and 4 on the left. One of the first things you will notice is the tubes coming out of one of the PCIe slots. That's because this one supports an optional liquid cooling solution with an inlet and outlet pipe. To the left, another PCIe slot. Under those, there is a USB 3.1 port, RJ45 port that can be configured for combo mode with iDRAC or as a network interface controller. Next, a mini display port, power button for the sled, micro AB USB port, also used for iDRAC access, the unit ID button, and the release lever for the sled. The other slot supports an OCP 3.0 mezzanine card. That optional OCP mezzanine card supports a number of network controller options with various speeds and ports. Power supplies supported for this unit include 1800 watts, 2400 watts, 2800 watts like we have here, and a 3200 watt option. Managing each server using the integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, or iDRAC, is through that management port on the back of each of the server nodes. Yes, there is only one RJ45 port, but that one can be set up with shared LAN on motherboard mode enabled. You can also access iDRAC through that micro AB USB port. We did do a short video on the iDRAC 9.0 Enterprise, which you can see here. While iDRAC is good for 1 or 2 servers, Dell's OpenManage utility is for managing multiple servers, storage, network switches, that kind of thing. OpenManage provides a more comprehensive overview of the entire network. Let's press on. Taking the cover off the chassis, you can see the two top server nodes, the fans, and the back where the drive backplane and drive cage would be located. That is, if this configuration had drives and a backplane. To either side of the 60mm cooling fan cartridges, you can see where the server node slides in and connects to the midplane, which is that small circuit board on the side of each node. A small 40mm fan provides air circulation over the midplane board and out the back through the PSUs. Notice the heavy power cables connecting to the chassis management board to the midplane connectors. Opposite the midplane board is an XMAX connector, which provides a high-speed backplane and I/O interconnect scalable from 25 gigabits per second up to 56 gigabits per second. The chassis management board is right in the middle between the server sleds, with the power distribution board closer towards the back of the chassis to connect with those stacked PSUs in back. The actual server sled has the potential for two risers in back and an OCP card slot. Risers supported include options for x16 and x8 PCI 5.0 slots. Using a snap I/O module in one of the PCI slots can increase I/O performance in a dual socket platform like the C6620. Snap I/O offers balanced performance by enabling both processors to share the network adapter without involving the UltraPath interconnect or UPI for communications between the processors, thereby maximizing bandwidth and performance. It's like having two NICs installed, with each feeding one of the dual CPUs. With Snap I/O, you only need that one. With limited PCI slots available, it's quite useful. Not to mention, you may need one of those slots for an HD controller if you go with SAS drives. Depending on which risers you have installed, and assuming no DLC, direct liquid cooling, to muck it all up, you can install two single-wide low-profile GPUs with a 75-watt power draw. You know, the usual candidates. The tried-and-true NVIDIA T4 with Turing architecture, or the NVIDIA A2 GPU featuring Ampere architecture. Both are fine options, with the T4 draining 75 watts of power and the A2 GPU consuming just 60 watts of power and only requires a PCI 4.0x8 slot. The T4 will need a PCI 3.0x16 slot, but you can probably get away with an open-end PCI 4.0x8 slot too. There are several limitations on using GPUs as a result of heat buildup, so consult the installation and service guide for specific applications. The LOM, or LAN on motherboard, can be switched out, as it too is a separate circuit board. Towards the front of the server node, where it connects to the chassis, you can see the power connector on one side, which mates up with the midplane connector and those red power cables. On the other is the XMAX backplane connector, enabling the server node to access those drives up front. Along the side of the chassis is a dedicated x8 PCI 4.0 slot for a BOSS N1 module that can support one or two M.2 SSDs in a hardware RAID, specifically to support the OS or hypervisor. Installing that optional bit of hardware will enable you to use those upfront drives for target applications instead of OS support. Outfitted with 5th generation Intel Xeon Scalable CPUs, each socket can provide up to 64 cores of processing power and 128 virtual threads. With 4th gen Intel Xeon Scalable processors installed, you can get up to 56 physical cores and 112 virtual threads. Those 5th gen CPUs support 8 memory channels, just like the 4th gen CPUs. But with the 5th gen, memory speed has increased from a top speed of 4800 megatransfers per second with Gen 4 up to 5600 megatransfers per second. With only 8 memory channels per socket and 8 memory module slots, memory speed is optimized. Only registered ECC DDR5 memory modules are supported. This platform can be used to support a variety of general purpose applications for e-commerce, database, data warehousing, and of course, high performance computing, to name a few. With dual socket server nodes capable of supporting up to 4 terabytes of memory, plus a choice of network connectivity, this platform can easily scale out to meet the needs going forward. I do hope you liked this short overview of the system. If you did, hit that subscribe button so you can tune in for our next server or workstation review. I did add a few links to the description for more information, but if you have any questions, post them in the comments section below. Looking for parts or components? Try itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.